Hi everyone. In this tutorial, we are going to cover the step-by-step process in order to run VisualSim using VisualSim Cloud. Now, these are the steps which I'm going to show you. For this, we need to get started. Now, you need to visit the Mirabilis Design website. And once you are on the website, you can go to the VisualSim Cloud, which is on the top right. Click on it. You will be redirected to a VisualSim Cloud page. Over here, we have launch, application demo, and library demo. You need to click on the launch. So this will redirect you to the VisualSim Online. So for the new users, we have two sections. The right section is the one you need to fill out. This is a form where you have to specify your name, company name, country, your telephone, and the planned usage. Or there's a university program also where you can, for the university students, where you can fill out all the details. Then click on submit. After doing so, you will get a email from Mirabilis Design where it will be specified the steps and the login information. So you will get two things. First is your username and then your password. Then what you have to do is you need to visit this page again, VisualSim Online. And as you can see at the left side, this section, login with email and password, you need to provide your username and you need to provide your password over here. Click on Remember Me, accept term and agreement. Click login. So once you do that, you will redirect it to the launch window page. Now from here, there are steps written that you can follow. So right now I'm going to show you how what are the steps in order to download the application software and to run the model example. Now for this, the first step is to download the OpenRevStart application. So since I'm using a Windows operating system, I will click on Windows. If you're on Linux or Mac OS, and you can use any of the suitable, whichever you are using. So for Windows, I click on here and this will download the ZIP file. So once this is downloaded, you need to visit to your download folder or wherever you're saving all the downloaded files. So for me, it is in the downloads folder. I go up here and I have a zip file already ready. So now what you need to do is extract it. Extract here. This will give you a executable file. So just run it, double click on it and run it. Okay. So since it is already installed for me, let me tell you how to install. Just you need to click on next, accept the agreement, next, 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 and then install it. So this will take few seconds and the installation process will be finished up. Now, before you go back to the website, I want you to show that you need to configure the OpenRevStart. So open the settings, OpenRevStart settings over here and click on it. So why do we need this is to let the OpenRevStart know that where is your JDK located on your system. So over here we have a JVM manager, the second option. Click on it. And for me, it is already located, but let me show you what it will look for you. So once you click on the JVM manager, it will look like something this, Adobe OpenJDK. So what you can do is you can click on the find local. So click on the find local. This will locate the all the JDKs that is installed in your system. And if for some reason you have not installed your JDK in a C directory and it is installed in some other drive, then what you can do is you can click on add local. Okay, this will open different dialog box, and then from here you can move to the destination JDK, wherever it is installed in D or E drive, and then just click on open. Make sure you give this location is you go up till JDK and whatever is the name, the version of the JDK. So it should be like this. Then you click on open and this will add your JDK over here. Once it is done, click on apply and then okay. Then go back to the Visual Sim Cloud, go back to the website and click on the launch button. Once you click on the launch button, you will get a warning message like this can harm your computer. So you do not need to worry about anything. Please press on keep. So then this will be also downloaded. Now this GNLP file is the one we are going to run. So let's go back to our download directory. Over here, I have a startup model or GNLP. Simply double click on it, run it. And this will take few seconds to open up a Visual Sim. Okay, so this opens a Visual Sim Architect. Now, one thing which I have not explained is related to, once you double click on this file, you will get a warning or permission message from JVM, which you have to click on run. For detailed documentation, it is present on the website. For detailed documentation, you can click on it and it will open up this PDF. So if you scroll down to the related error or permission, you will get these, you can get these type of warning messages from JVM. What you have to do is you have to click enable this and then simply run. Or if you do not get this type of things, then you might get this. So what you have to do is remember this option for this site. Why it is necessary to do this so that you do not have to give this, every time you start a model, you do not have to go through this process again and again. So that's why just remember this option, click on this and yes. So this will complete the warning messages and you do not have to worry about any other things. So once it is done, this will be opened up and you can start with the modeling or you can start with the demo models which are present under file, open template list. So once you do that, you will get, we have assembled like 29 models for the users to get started. You can click on any of the models. Suppose I click on the first one, I get this new window about this model. You can simply run it, go through the documentation, or you can create your own custom model using traffic and simulator. This is just a demo that I'm trying to show you over here. So you can create your own model and you can simply run it. Okay. And there are options where you can save your model also. So save as and go to the specific directory where you want to save your models. So that's how it will work. And then you can also open your models, stored model anytime you want. So this is all about the Visual Sim Cloud. And thank you very much for joining us.